Hey, how's it going, guys? This is xsinick. Welcome to the xsinick show. Today we're gonna do some concept art and that kind of thing. So I just realized that some of the shows that I've been doing hasn't been published for anyone to look at after. So if you look after the fact, after watching this video, if you look before the videos before this, I kind of launched them just a few minutes ago, so you can look and see what I've done up to this point, right? So so I'm trying to be on as regular as possible every day at some point. Please just follow me here on Twitch, and you could also follow me on YouTube, but mostly on Twitch, and you'll be able to see when I post stuff because it will notify you and let you know. Yeah, and follow me on this journey, man. Hopefully this game is gonna kick a lot of butt, and it's gonna look cool and whatever it is. And hopefully my loyal viewers, if you come on here and you make yourself known, would be able to get certain special things to do with the game and with other games and giveaways and prizes and all that. So just to let you know, there'll be a special announcement, and I'm gonna try to do a prize giveaway tomorrow. For anyone that makes it a week with me. So if you come on every day for a week, and when I say a week, I mean like Monday to Friday, right? For at least 5 days, and I make note of that. I'm gonna try to give away something away. If you have Steam, that'll be even better because I could gift you something on Steam. So we're gonna start this giveaway stuff. It's free just for those who watch and those who interact with me on the stream. So that's how it is. All right, so let's get going with what we have today. So today, what I'm gonna do, we're gonna continue fixing up some of the enemy robots, doing some concept art design. So let's type that out, man. Let's see. So today, today we are doing more concept art design. Designing let's put enemy robots. So before, in the past, just to let you guys know, it's not just about character design. I also do environments, and we'll eventually do this in 3D. So, but right now we're doing the 2D part. So get in on it, right? Tell your friends to come and check me out, and you guys can hang out. We could talk about anything. We talk about anime. We talk about the new movies that's out. Last night I watched the Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania. They did a pretty good job, and it seemed like there wasn't any preachy agendas or any kind of weird social justice or woke. It seemed like there was no woke stuff in there, which was pretty cool. It seemed to me like a straightforward movie. I could be wrong. People could probably see more things in there, but that's what I seen so far. So, all right, guys. With that said, let's jump right into doing some of this artwork, man. That's what we're here for, right? Yeah. All right. Straight to the desktops. Okay, so let's fire up what... You know how we do it. Let's fire up the GIMP. I'll just post in chat here what we're doing today. Yeah, so that's what we're doing today. Okay, so yeah, let's jump in here and get it going. You know what? It looked as if like I need to adjust chat for some reason. I'm just gonna take a quick look at that. Yeah, I think I have to adjust chat. Let's do that. Okay, I just had to adjust the chat box there. I realized it was cutting off stuff. These are some of the things that you gotta do from time to time. All right, yeah, let's get in there. All right, so we're here in the GIMP. We're gonna do it. And if you think, you know, like I'm a little bit chatty, it's because I don't have anybody to chat with, you know. We're gonna try to talk about a process. This is a little tutorial-y. Okay, so I made like little shortcuts to the folder. Mm-hmm. Oh, I have my email going. I think I'm gonna shut that down here. You know, so you could check me out on Discord. You could check me out on YouTube. Steam, of course. And Instagram to some degree. SoundCloud. Okay, let's see here. You're going to concept art, character design, enemies. We were at the soldier level at one point, so let's go in here. Oh yeah, we did some. So what we did some touch ups to the soldier enemy robot body. Save that, and we did some heads, so we're gonna stick the heads on the body now to get different heads. You have a little bit of variation. These are all the heads, so I'm gonna open one up and then dump the rest of the designs in here. This is one head. You know, fire up this yeah, just kind of firing up this browser right here. Okay, these are different heads. Actually, these heads are for Soldier A, so I'm just gonna cut that here. Raw generator and drop these heads in here like we did with the last ones. Come on. You can do it. There we go. Boinks. And then we're in B. And raw generated. That's heads here too. Okay. So we drop this guy in here. Let's just make sure the first guy is actually that guy. Yep. We're gonna just drop the other guys in. Let's see if this works. Oh, that worked. The gimp is hot. Yep, that's what we want. And we're gonna pick and choose the elements we want on this guy. All right, so let's stick with this first guy, right? I like what's going on to the top there, so we're gonna keep that part of that guy. So I'll show you a different way to do it. I like this right here. Remember, we just keep things a little loose. And we could always go over and paint over, right? So the end goal should never be the concept art. The concept art is just to inform the design of the final kind of character. Right, and we could take this and we could tell it. Actually, let's hit that. Oops, let's go back. What's going on here? Okay. Then enter, and then we're gonna right click on here, and I'm gonna tell it add layer mask, but I'm gonna do selection. Vice, it keeps that guy. So we like that on that guy. Let's see if there's anything else on. Oh yeah, let's put this guy on the bottom. Okay, so we like that. I like the ears on this guy. So we're gonna keep the ears on that guy. Let's look at the neck. Neck, not so much right now. Yeah, so we're gonna keep the ears on this guy. And what I'm gonna do later is to make sure and go back. Touch it up, something like that. Let's select this part here. The good thing about making these things mask is that you can adjust the mask after the fact. There we go. Let's look for like a neck. Nope, definitely not that guy. I'm liking that guy's neck. Yeah, let's use this guy. Drop him on the bottom. Yep. And let's see for like the front face part. That's not good. So this guy is out. Let's get rid of this guy. Yeah, this guy's not good. So I guess it looks great like this. Just as is just so. Let's deselect all that. Yeah, so that's what this is what we come up with so far, guys. I'm just gonna add this to this see, is this the top half? Yep. Just come and add this part here. Okay, we got that there like that. And this is the ears, right? Oops. This one a little blurry. Yeah, it's on a little blend. Something like that. It's gonna turn the opacity down on this and just gonna see if I can guess kinda hide the seam here by just running a little bit. Oops. Copy X. Yeah. Let's do something like that. Okay, merge this down. Okay, merge down. Okay, so this is head one. I'm just gonna save this. And I'm just using my mouse. I'm not jumping into the Wacom as yet. Whoa. Just grab his head and drop this on this guy just to see, if it works out. Let's do this and just see. Wow, the big head is kind of cool, but nope. Just zoom in a bit. Wow, the small head and big body is something else. Let's do something like this. Yeah, let's do this. Head is almost as equal to the size of the shoulder. A little bit smaller. Let's bring it down a little bit. Okay, I see the interpolation low halo scale. Alright, I'm just gonna drop a little levels on this to sharpen it back up. Okay, let's drop a mask on this guy. We're gonna go full black. Alright, and now we're gonna jump over to the Wacom. I'm gonna use my Wacom. Check the one opacity all the way up. Okay, well, I can dig it. Bring it back onto the. Okay. It needs a little contrast. Let's try that. Put some levels. Okay, so there you go. One guy, drop a little levels on him. I mean a little, let's give it a little saturation. Yeah, let's bring that up like everything else. Okay, so we getting there. First head, duplicate that. Push that down, save. Okay, let's see this guy now. Not bad. Let's see what we're keeping in this guy. I like that guy. This guy's neck is kind of cool. Let's see somebody else. Not bad. Oh. I'm so glad we only have a few of this guy. So I think this guy, his neck is, let's put him on the bottom. Yeah, this guy's lower half is pretty cool. Let's see, does this guy have any redeeming qualities in the face? Not really. Yeah, so I don't really like this guy. Let's get rid of him. Oh, we only have three of that guy? Yeah, this guy's top half, like the top right part of his face is kind of cool. Okay, let's do that. The parts I like is like this. Just go in and do it for this. Let's go. Oop. Cancel. Oh yeah, and there's a little part here in the thing that I liked, so I'm going to see if I could get that back. Let's make a hole there. Yep, that I thought that was cool. Not sure what that is trying to be. It's trying to be something. Yeah, let's double check that heads folder. I thought that's all for that head. I guess that was all. There's three? Hey, you know what? That's enough. I'm just gonna give this a little bit more dimension on there. I'm just gonna select these flat parts here and give them a little bit more interest. Really rough. I'm drawing with a mouse, guys. Alright. What I'm gonna do here is just to drop a little bit of a highlight. You know, select this. Something like that. Oh, come on. Just to give it a little, give a little blockhead here, a little poppy, turn that on a smidgen. Other than, you know, just this, yeah, that's all. So you got to merge that down. This guy. I'm gonna drop like a levels on this guy while I'm here. Make the levels a little. Okay. Let's drop him here. Headed to. Make this a little bit smaller than that. Let's do a little bit smaller. Little bit smaller. Okay. Drop a mask on this guy. Okay, let's put him in a wake on. And let's bring the head in. Okay, let's go X. Let's make this brush a little bit smaller. Let's clean up the edges here. Okay, I'm gonna. That seems fine. Let's fix this guy a little bit. Okay. Okay, let's check this guy out. Bring him back onto here. Okay, so he's more reminiscent of the original design. Guy, we have that guy. Okay, there's some variation there, and save this. At least we have one more head. This guy might be a little bit tricky, so I'm gonna look for like a good neck. Definitely not that guy. That's interesting. Kind of like that. Not that guy. That's interesting. No, not that guy. So, that's interesting. Not that guy. That's interesting. So, between these two. I like the lower half of, I like the face of this guy. Yeah, let's pick the lower half. Let's pick this guy out. I'm gonna take the lower half of him. Before I continue, let's take a quick peek at somebody else. Okay. Up. Okay, let's just pick this guy up one while we're here. Looking for a good top half. I like what's going on with the head. No with the visor though. So let's pick out what we want. Let's pick this guy top part here, his head. I'm liking the visor part because it's kind of solid. Let's see if that'll work. I think so. Yeah, I think the solid visor is gonna work. So let's pick that out here. It's not in the airpiece of this guy's, it's kind of working, so we'll keep that bottom guy there. Yeah, this part here is kind of working. Let's see what this guy is about. Nope. Get rid of that guy. Maybe the plate down here is kind of working for this guy. Let's just bring that little piece in. Just gonna try to grab some pieces here. Yeah, this guy's a no. So I think we kind of have a guy here, head. Okay, let's get a nice soft brush. Let's try the airbrush. Turn that hardness down. Okay, that works for now. Let's go down. It's the top part. Little hat. Blend the hat here. Okay. This is a face mask here. Make this a little smaller brush. Okay, what's going on here? Oh, and there's another piece. Let's blend that. Get rid of that. Okay.
this part here. Yep, blend that a little bit. Yeah, I think that's it's a head. Just drop it into this guy here. Head three. Smaller. Make it a little bit smaller. Okay. Now let's merge it in now. So we go to the Wacom, drop a mask on that, and let's get it popping. Let's get it happening. Popping. That's fun. Let's go. All right. Okay, so that's the other head. I'm thinking about this thing here, this weapon. Yeah, it's like the weapon needs to be flipped around. It needs to be held more in the hand. So I'm gonna do a Frankenstein on this. When I say Frankenstein, I mean like to like go in there and just like grab stuff and cut and paste stuff out of, you know, where it shouldn't be and paste it where I think it should be. Just gonna do something like this. Give me some leeway here. Okay, so it's a copy, paste. So let's check this out. Rotate. See, something like that. I think it should be like this. Did that work? We're about to find out if this is gonna work. I'm just gonna add a little mask on this guy. Okay, let's go to the Wacom and see if we can get some more control over this. Single pixel, bigger single pixel brush. Okay, it needs to be shifted. Let's grab it. Why is this unmove path? Yeah, I don't want to move active power, move a layer. Move active layer. Okay, there we go. Okay. Back on Trezak. a lot of JPEG compression and all that sort of stuff. Again, you know, if you're watching at any point of this video, the point of this is not to make beautiful concept art. It's just to inform designs for 3D later on. Okay, I'm gonna zoom out and take a look. He's holding it kind of awkwardly, but that's fine. It's a robot. Yeah, I think this is fine. And then we're gonna do some stuff to make it more of a weapon. So it's definitely a thing he's holding. I think I'm gonna wrap the finger around here, wrap this thumb around here, and get rid of that. Okay, let's do that. Something like this, get rid of that. We can get rid of the finger here. Yeah, and then I'll repaint it. Okay, so let's just merge. Okay, let's go directly. Let's go do some direct painting. Okay, I have an idea. Let's see if this idea works. I have an idea what this should be. Oh. Okay, it's just concept art, guys. I'm not gonna get too crazy into it. Not too crazy. Alright, so this is the idea I have. Let's do something like this. Alright, let's go a little bit more in there, and I'm gonna zoom out. Make it a little bit wider. Okay, here we go. Okay, that's my big surprise. Yes, it's an electric baton thing. It just shocks you with it. Eh, it's an idea, right? I'm gonna put some of that purple here. Make it really purple. Touch that. Okay, just tie it in a little bit. Yeah, yeah, so what, give him like purple ribcage things. And it could technically be a lot slimmed up. Let's see. Just cut this guy down. Like so. Cut into here, cut down so. Something like that. So it feels more robotic, I guess. Cut that like so. You can see a little more hips than him, but just cut that across. If there's anything that I learned with doing character design, is that silhouettes are very important. Okay. It's a little bit better. Boom. Bad guy. See what happens here if you do like a color hue. I'll select anything to do with like blue. Let's go a little overlap. Yeah, add a little variation to that. A lot more overlap. Yeah, give it a little more into that blue. Alright, so this is one guy. It's another guy. Actually, his other hand should have the baton, or should be that electric baton. This hand should be the electric thing, and you know what? We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. Okay, let's save. Let's go back into my desktop screen, and let's save this. Looks like that's that thing there. Okay, let's save this. Final, right? The color, and you know, I'm not too fond of the purple color. I'm looking at it now, but you know, we could always change that, right? I think purple denotes that the body, the gray body, should be a little bit darker to kind of match in there with it. And maybe it should. If that gray, this gray body is a lot darker, then everything else is gonna work. I wonder if I could do that. Let's see. Head. You see different heads, and then these guys should have like a more purpley vibe going with them. So let's see. Let's see if we could do something like that. No, this is where layers come into to play. If you had the layers, everything would work out. I'm gonna purposefully try to select everything except the red. So there's a selection like a selection box where you can keep track of your selections here in the GIMP. Let's look for that. Selection editor, yep, that's what it is. Let's just go crudely and use this. Alright, so I'm gonna shove the selection editor right here. Got a low threshold. A higher threshold. Okay, let's see what other options we have for selections. Select by color, of course. We select all the reds. Everything with pigment. So many variations of red. Okay, so this is rough. So we could do a slight feather on this. Selection, feather. Okay, and I'm gonna invert the selection. Select everything except that, and let's just drop a levels on this. Actually, let's see if we could select the gray. This is some really rough selection stuff, but this is what we gotta do. Okay, good selection is Photoshop, like 32. Let's go lower than that. Alright, so we give ourselves a rough selection. And let's drop a feather on this. Oop. See one thing here I could invert it. select this guy. Okay, let's see if we can darken this guy up. Drop a levels on this guy. Something like that. Okay, and I'm gonna drop this as a multiply and see what that's gonna do. Alright, so this really darkens him up, which is great. I'm just gonna slowly bring up this black. I like the black. Let's back away on that a bit. That works. Just lighten it up just a smidgen. I'm gonna come in here with a smudge tool and just smudge some parts. Whoa, it's a little heavy. Turn the hardness down, turn the force down a smidge. Just run it through. Quick ways to do things. Can I get rid of that sharp anti-aliased edge a little bit? It's not going to totally get rid of it, but it's going to make it look a little bit better than what it was. I think just a little more black is better. Let's go 80. I'm gonna back away and lady, I go 70. Let's try for some more levels, see what happens. Go like that, spring out the brights. Let's do some of that. Yes, yeah, back away in some of that darkness. Let's go 70. Let's keep it like about there. It's better than having it. Well, the bright is not bad. Yeah, let's keep it somewhat shadowy like that. What I'm gonna do, just darken the background just a smidgen. Crazy. That's destroying the image, right? I'm already kind of destroying the image a little bit. Hey, those red bits are really sticking out. Yeah, they kind of cut out Halo around. That's fine. You know, the brightness is not bad. You know what, let's go 70, let's go 65. Yeah, that's not bad. Alright, so I think that's working so far. Okay, let's save this. Let's save these guys. Go tools. Let's go like that with a gray. Let's pump up the. And you could add like a highlight to make the image a lot prettier and for things, you know. But no, we're just leaving it like this. We're not gonna make it overly pretty right now. And plus, in any ways, if you was to redo this, you'd have to paint the whole thing over. This is seriously just compositing. We're just compositing for you know, just to make sure it, we get some cool stuff happening here. Some sharp mask. Save. Okay. Yeah, so there's a lot of things that could be fixed on this, but for now, we're fine. We fix this guy here. Let's leave that like that. There's a lot could be fixed on here. I think like maybe the purple could ring through to some of the joints. Yeah, stuff like that. Let's see. See what will happen. again, you know, like, you could definitely get into like, oh, let's make this piece look really nice. But that's kind of not what this is about. At least not what I'm about with this stuff right now. Yeah, let's not get too much into the weeds with this stuff. Okay, I'm getting too much into it, guys. I'm gonna back away a bit. Just jump back into I was on my desktop. I forgot to switch over to the Wacom. That's fine, guys. I was too much into it here and started to work on the joints a little bit. Yeah, so you know, the work could be done on this. You know, like right here, work could be really done on this, but I'm not gonna do too much. Yep, I'm gonna darken this part here though. Oop! Oh, come on, Nick. Color levels, just drop a little, yeah, it's a little darkness in that, yeah, okay, something like that, yeah, whatever. All right, yeah, so, you know, getting some of that kind of like evil bad guy purple in there. He's a bad guy because there's, you know, I guess evil purple and there's like electric, you know, you know, and then it's supposed to be reflections from the light, and you could just go to town and like really work this out, and I think this is fine. So let's move on. I'm just gonna save this guy over again. And maybe these guys have something different about them. I'm thinking maybe this could be like a bow staff. Wow, just thought of that. That's bingo. Like a two-sided like thing. Let's see if we could get that happening. Okay, let's rotate this guy. Oh yeah. Yeah, that's what's up. Boom. Bow Staffy. Hotness. That's it, guys. Look at that, a little experimentation and not being afraid to like switch things up a little bit. And before you know it, you got like a cool weapon, right? Oh, come on, go back. Select, edit. We do move there. Okay. Boom. I could flip it so that the lighting is correct on it. Yeah, let's do that. I think it might mess it up. Let's see. Layer. Where's my No. Put it back the way it was. It's fine. It's concept art, guys. We could touch things up after the fact. The important thing is that we get the concept down, right? Yeah, so that's the new weapon, the bow staff. Woo! Yeah, we Frankenstein this guy to like smithereens, like completely destroying the art. And then we could go in and just keep adjusting the keep painting, doing paint overs and all that sort of stuff. It's like a thick pole, like, you know, hit you on either side with it. Oops, didn't see that. Get that airbrush happening. A little bit of hardness on there. All right, let's save. Oh yeah, that merges down. Save this. Come in with this guy here. All right, save this guy. Save this guy. I think this guy's thing needs to be ducked back a bit. So boom, electric bow staff. Like electric tube bow staff. Awesome. Alright, so let's see, so we've got that happening. Save this, save the original. Okay, let's open the different versions of it. Just different heads, and like, why are you doing different heads off of the same? So maybe, you know, you have like different properties for these guys. That's something I could think about later. Maybe it's like this guy first, then that guy, and then boom, this guy is like crazy. Keep destroying it with the levels a little bit. Yep, that's good. Okay, so that takes care of that guy. So discard all these. Okay, let's see. Let's bring these guys out. And maybe they could have like different colors, right? And it could mean different things. And let's see. Yeah, this is still a soldier, right? So soldier A, B. Let's go into soldiers A. So these, yeah, so like these guys mean different things. It's more of a kind of assault rifle. This guy's more of a sniper. So it's long range, short range, and medium range. And this is a short range guy. Short range guy. Medium range guy. Long range guy. So maybe there's some way that I could differentiate these guys, you know. So maybe the long arm could stick for this guy, so this guy could still like grab you with his long arm. Maybe that's what that is, you know. And I could redesign this arm so that it does special things, and maybe he does not need this this bow staff for this guy. Maybe this guy needs a bow staff. Let's see. Right, and he does not have a long arm. So we could do some more with these things. So okay, we're gonna take a little break. It's like around like 12. And I'll be right back, guys. You know, and we'll try to vary these guys up a little bit more so that it makes sense in different with the different things that they could do. Alright, so take it easy. Maybe your guy's a grenade, like just grenade, like grenades that could shock or something. You know, we could go into this like, you know, as a painting and just repaint everything. All right then, so the important thing is that we have something that looks somewhat okay. That's the important thing. All right, so I'll see you guys in a little bit. This is xsinick, you know. We'll see you in a minute. Thanks for hanging out with me for this first part of the video. We're going to keep chugging them out as much as we can. And yeah, remember, you know, just remember to follow me and tell your friends and everything like that. And when you come in here, you know, we could chat about different things, about movies and about so many other things. All right, so I'll see you in a little bit. God bless. Bye-bye.